ورسوله والمؤمنون وستردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. No, he was he wanted to say yeah. You're coming? Yeah, please.
That's because it's not a free word, right? Because the deen that says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you take one step towards him, he'll take two steps towards you, like many steps towards you, not just he'll take steps towards you, you have to make the opening battle.
Where is our back? No, that's Ismail.
He should be coming soon.
He's coming soon.
He's coming at 9, 5 more minutes.
If you want me, I can keep talking.
Let's keep talking. Please continue.
Or maybe I you know, I hate to bore you. Are you bored?
No.
You are not bored?
أخذ بالأسباب.
Well, first of all, I have to thank you very much for allowing me to talk to you. And I thank you for listening to my broken English.
And thank you to
thank you.
And for enjoying my heavy Egyptian accent. Okay? Well, that topic, I wish you understand the issue of this talk. Okay, and that same issue goes hand in hand with a shafa'ah. After all, Sayyidina Nuh was doing shafa'ah for his dua, for his son. Sayyidina Ibrahim was interceding, you know, for his father. Sayyidina Muhammad was trying also for Abdullah ibn Ubayy ibn Salul, Ra's al-Nifaq. When these two ayahs came, Astaghfir lahum aw la akhiri. So, so actually, it goes in the same line with the Shafa'ah. Shafa'ah was mentioned in the Quran in 20 surahs, and it was mentioned 26 times. بنفس اللفظ الشفاعة يشفع شفيع. Okay. But because of the time limit, I'm not going to go, you know, through the whole 26 times, but I selected just 7 ayat from 7 surahs. The first one in Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah number 2, verse 255. And it is again Ayat Al-Kursi. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Is there a Quran here? Sheikh Yusuf Ali? No, that's not the... Okay. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Who is going to intercede? Who is going to intercede unless allows that intercession? wish my Quran because I put 255.
Are you looking for your
help? No. Why? Actually, من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه. Here Allah will permit the shafa'ah, but not before His permission. Okay? Now, when we talk about the shafa'ah, some people denied it. Dr. Mustafa Mahmoud wrote about that. I don't know if he changed his mind after that or not. I'm not aware of that, but I have a book written by him, and he was one of the people that denied the Shafa'ah. Some people say, no, it is there, but they rely on it. They rely on it. يُنْكِرُهَا الْبَعْضُ وَيَعْتَقِدْ أَخَرُونَ أَنَّهَا طَرِيقُ إلى جنة الخلد.
I'm sorry to interrupt you because Allah wants to ask you to talk about the Ramah. هو غير رأيه لأن الأخير.
I hope.
وموجود على YouTube.
That is سورة البقرة آية الكرسي. سورة يونس. ما من شفيع إلا من بعد إذنه. It's very clear. No intercession unless with the leave of Allah. Again, the leave of Allah, the permission of Allah. Surah Maryam, 19:87. لَا يَمْلِكُونَ الشَّفَاعَةَ إِلَّا مَنِ اتَّخَذَ عِنْدَ الرَّحْمَنِ عَادًا. So the angels, because who is going to do the shafa'ah? Who is going to be shafi'a عند Allah? Al-ibad al-salihin. Either the angels or the prophets and messengers. Even though they are angels and prophets and messengers, but they still do not own the shafi'a. It has to come after Allah's permission. إِلَّا مَنِ اتَّخَذَ عِنْدَ الرَّحْمَنِ عَهْدًا. Promise from Allah. Surah Taha, Ayah 109, Surah number 20. يَوْمَئِذٍ لَا تَنْفَعُ الشَّفَاعَةِ إِلَّا مَنْ أَذِنَ لَهُ الرَّحْمَنِ وَرَضِيَ لَهُ قَوْلًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have to, number one, give the permission. Number two,